Hi! In the last video, we learned how to take advantage of the math package. In this episode, we learn how to use the signal analysis function. We are going to learn how to set up various signal analyzers and how to benefit from the signal analysis function. Have you ever wondered how much fluid has left the tank in a defined time interval? With the signal analysis tool, you can even choose the time base you would like to see the totalized values. By default, analysis 2, 3, and 4 are set to a daily, monthly, and an annual basis. However, we have the option to adjust these intervals to a different duration or an external trigger, such as a digital input signal from the PLC or any other source. In this case, we would like to know how much fluid has left the tank after 15 minutes. Therefore, we set the first analyzer to 15 minutes. Afterwards, we can display the totalizer that resets every 15 minutes. We navigate to the signal groups menu, choose an available display slot, or in our case, change the flow totalizer to intermediate analysis, which is the signal analysis time we just defined in the last step. On the main screen, we can see that we now have a flow totalizer that totalizes the flow for 15 minutes and resets afterwards. The same functionality is available for other time bases as well. These individually recorded measurement intervals come in relevant once we combine the data logging function of the RSG45 or the RSG35 with a post-processing software like our Field Data Manager, FDM. After importing and processing the data, we can compress all our recorded data into relevant and easy-to-read reports to keep track of our process. With the signal analysis function, we receive key indicators like minimum, maximum, average value of the defined interval. Check out our FDM video series to learn more about data storage and post-processing software. This function could have a huge benefit for your application. If you're interested in the totalized process values of one batch, you can also batch trigger this function to receive an accurate reference value for an individual time span. In the next episode, we are going to use and take advantage of the limit function that comes as a standard with the RSG45. Thank you.